In this video, I will discuss the investigation of an enlarged thyroid and its management. I urge you to watch the video on the workup of a thyroid nodule. Although it pertains to a single nodule, it is also valid for multiple nodules, especially a dominant nodule in a multinodular goiter. As for diffuse goiter, laboratory workup usually suffices. It is truly unknown what percentage of nodules harbor malignancy, because most figures date from a time before the high prevalence of nodules were known. My advice is to simply investigate each case properly. Patients with small asymptomatic goiters can simply be followed up by sonographic evaluation on a regular basis and need no treatment. If any of the named symptoms arise because of size, you can embark on a trial of thyroxine suppressive therapy. There is a large placebo-controlled double-blind randomized trial that has shown effective shrinkage in almost 60% of patients at 9 months, and this is certainly valid treatment. Nodules appear to be more difficult to manage with thyroxine though, with a lower response rate. In 2002, a meta-analysis appeared that showed no difference in nodule shrinkage between thyroxine and placebo, but later that year a French group published a randomized control trial that did show a significant better response with thyroxine. Further research to identify the subgroups that do benefit is clearly needed. What must be noted is that most nodules grow again after discontinuing treatment. Thyroxine must therefore be considered long-term, and this raises the question of safety. There have been many reports of the effect on the heart and bone of individuals on long-term suppressive therapy. Some show a detrimental effect and some do not. Lastly, it must be remembered that both hyperplastic and neoplastic nodules can respond to thyroxine therapy, and its use to differentiate these are not advised. It is only after workup, as I have outlined in the video on the workup for a thyroid nodule and the determination that it is benign, that you can consider the use of thyroxine to manage a nodular goiter. If thyroxine therapy fails or is not considered to manage a symptomatic non-toxic diffuse, uninodular or multinodular goiter, radioactive iodine and surgery are your alternative. Surgery used to be the decision of choice, but radioactive iodine therapy has been shown to be a viable alternative. The indication for radioactive iodine therapy used to be the elderly who were unfit for surgery on those with recurrences after surgery. A randomized trial comparing radioactive iodine therapy and thyroxine suppression has shown a nearly 40% reduction at 1 year and nearly 50% reduction in thyroid size at 2 years in 97% of patients. Substernal extension with compression and the fear of enlargement directly after radioactive iodine therapy with resultant asphyxia is greatly exaggerated. And studies with serial sonographic follow-up after radioactive iodine therapy have shown no significant volume increase. Indeed, it has been shown by MRI that patients with compression by non-toxic goiters with substernal extension have less tracheal deviation and an increase in tracheal lumen size. There are side effects to radioactive iodine therapy and certain contraindications and consequences, and for these I refer you to the videos dealing with radioactive iodine therapy in the series on Graves' disease. Please watch it. Surgery is the mainstay of therapy for symptomatic patients. It provides a specimen for histological evaluation, it avoids radiation, it provides for single-stage treatment, and has a low risk of recurrence. The choices between bilateral subtotal, unilateral total and contralateral subtotal, and total thyroidectomy. The more extensive the surgery, the more likelihood of hypothyroidism, but the less the chance of recurrence. In the hands of a competent surgeon and with single parathyroid autotransplantation, most authorities prefer a total thyroidectomy with post-operative thyroxine replacement. When thyroid remnants are left behind, thyroxine may still be required should hypothyroidism develop. Thyroxine replacement plays no role in the prevention of recurrence though, as it has been shown not to be preventative.